All right, we are live on Periscope, getting a hang of this whole camera thing, how it works. Hey, what's happening? Thank you for joining. We'll give everybody a few seconds to hop on here and figure this all out. Remember to, I guess you still can't share this thing, huh? I don't, or there may be a way. Maybe you can, when there's a replay, you can copy and paste that or something like that. And make sure to hit the heart button. Lots of hearts, lots of hearts. Hearts, they say, are good, and it helps us get people to involved and join in. So yeah, tap away. We can tap as many times as we want. This isn't like Facebook where it's only one tap and you're done. Anyways, really quick. I know it's probably early morning, late morning, late evening, wherever you are. I wanted to give you a couple things. I'm attending a training right now, and I love learning, and it's so important because, you know, the more you learn, you're gonna help determine how you want to think, how you want to see the world, all those things. Mindset is crucial, right? Because we're always cultivating a mindset. We always are, and we're always deliberate about the mindset we're cultivating. And now think about that. A lot of times we think, oh, I just think so negative. I think this. I think that. But then let's examine how we think. Let's examine the stuff we watch. Right? If we're sitting there watching the news a bunch, is there really anything that inspiring or that motivational in the news? I don't know. And if there is, let me know what news you're watching, because every time I'm in the gym and I happen to flip through it, it's not the most inspiring stuff. Versus being deliberate about it and saying, okay, well, instead of watching this, I'm going to do this. Instead of reading this, I'm going to read that. Right? There's more people, I mean, there's people out there who spend more time learning about celebrities who they don't even know who they are than they do what's going on in their own kids' life. And then they wonder why life doesn't seem like it's okay. There's more people that are spending time connecting with, you know, online gossip columns and who's sleeping with who than they are talking with their own spouse, their own husband, their own wife about what's going to make a better relationship for them, about what's going to make their relationship higher quality. And I was inspired this morning because I went on to the Zero Limits Mastermind group, and one of the group members was getting ready for a road trip. And she posted a photo, and all she had was probably like 12 different personal development books and audio CDs. And that's what I mean. That's being deliberate, right? That's taking action. That's deciding, okay, this is the mindset I want to have. And I'm committed to doing it, so I'm going to listen to all these books. I'm going to read all these books. I'm going to literally flood my brain with this kind of stuff. And then after that, I was chatting with a client who's over in Germany or something like that, and he was telling me about the books that he's reading right now and about the way it's, you know, just maybe some subtle mindset shifts in him. That's being deliberate. He's over on vacation and he's still taking the time to put in his mind the stuff he wants to think. He's cultivating how he wants to think, and then thus it's going to replicate how he feels. You see, we have to be deliberate because we're always are deliberate. Think about that. Again, we're always deliberate. The stuff we put in, it just doesn't go in by accident. It's what we're inundating ourselves with. Watching the news, listening to music, right? Reading what we read, thinking what we think, all that stuff affects what goes on in here. So if you don't like what's going on in here, look at what you're putting in. Don't watch the stuff you've been watching. Don't read what you've been reading. Don't listen to what you've been listening to. I can tell you guys, like, as the more time I've spent developing my mindset and cultivating, I found that I've had less and less of a tolerance for certain things. Personal example, for whatever reason, I'm a sucker for the horror movie genre. Every now and then I like to give myself a good scare. And I think it started because when I was a little kid, and you remember like being a little kid when you get really scared about something, and it was so scary that it was real. Well, that was what Jaws was like for me. And I can remember the first time watching Jaws and sitting there watching it. And make sure you're clicking the heart button, everybody. I remember watching Jaws and just being so terrified. And the part where he's in the little jetty area, and there's a guy in the boat and the kid's in the water, and he's sitting there asking the kid if he's okay, and thank you for clicking the hearts. And he goes up, and then the next thing you see is you see the guy going underwater and you see his leg floating down. And I lost it. I literally lost my shit. I mean, I was probably 5, 6 years old. I'm in the bathroom crying after that. I never forget my mom coming and knocking on the door, asking if he wanted to pause the movie and wait for me to get out. I was like, no, no, keep it going. And then for the next, gosh, I don't know how many times, years of my life, I had my closest childhood friend growing up, his family happened to have Jaws, the movie. And every time I'd have a sleepover at his house, I'd make myself watch that movie because I was so set on overcoming that fear. You know, when you get that mindset right, that you just, again, you've gotten into this determined mindset that you're going to get over whatever it is you need to get over, no matter what. And that's how Jaws was with me. And so I'm watching this every time, and I remember so many times he'd fall asleep, and I'd be so pissed out of me. I'd be so pissed at him because he would be asleep over there, a little drool coming out of his mouth, and I'm still up there with a sheet, you know, barely up to my eyes trying to get through Jaws. Needless to say, you know, 30 times later, and I don't know how many years passed, and I finally am able to watch Jaws, and I don't get terrified. I can appreciate it for what it is. And I think that affinity for scaring myself kind of stuck with me. Well, what I've noticed lately now is there's certain kinds of horror movies I can still enjoy. The, you know, the monster movies, the ones that are pretty fictitious. There's no real realism and stuff. But the ones that have a suggestion of realism to them, I have a harder time digesting it. I happened to watch this movie maybe 2 weeks ago before I went to bed. And, you know, the movie wasn't anything particularly great. I don't remember what the name of it was. But it was a more, you know, plausible scenario. Like, maybe this could happen. And I went to bed and I wasn't scared, but I felt uneasy. I didn't feel good inside. And I remember going to bed and my little heart was palpating, and I woke up in the middle of the night and my heart was racing. I'm thinking, gosh, that really affected me a lot more than I thought it would. It really affected me a lot more than I thought it would. It's kind of like, you know, when you've been in a really warm environment for a while, you go and maybe you have a heat wave, or you're on a vacation somewhere and it's warm, and then you go back and all of a sudden the weather's cold, it hits you harder than it used to, right? You forgot how cold feels. Or maybe if you're living in a cold environment, it gets really hot, all of a sudden you forgot how hot feels. It was like that. I had forgotten how uneasy it felt to be uneasy. Because I'd been spending so much time cultivating my mindset, I've been spending so much time just developing how I want to think and feel, right? So it's such an important thing, because we're always going to be deliberate about making our mindset and creating our emotional state. So if we're always going to be deliberate about that, we might as well be deliberate about what we put in here, right? We have an option. You have an option. There's nobody force feeding you to watch certain TV shows, listen to certain music, reading certain things or whatnot. That's you, right? That's totally, totally you. And you can decide and change it. If you have, you know what, I get made fun of all the time by friends because I literally have the same music playlist I've had for, gosh, probably over 10 years. Oh, thanks for all the hearts. And they sit there and give me shit. Oh, there's nothing modern on here. There's nothing this, there's nothing that. And I said, you know what, for me, I have them. It brings emotions that I want. See, when I listen to music, I don't want to be sitting there and going through this, going through that. I want to feel specific emotions. I want to elicit a certain emotional response. I want to listen to music that's going to lift me up, that's going to energize me, it's going to make me stoked on things, that makes me happy and I sing along to. And so I have my songs that do that for me. Now, am I opposed to adding anything else? Not at all. Every now and then there will be a new one that comes out and I think, oh, this is great, I'm going to add it on there. But that's few and far between. I'm very deliberate about what I let go in here. And then there's a lot of times where if I'm out in public or I'm somewhere and the music's going on, it's not the music I normally listen to or I'd really like. It doesn't sit well. You know, it gives you that kind of that uneasy feeling. Have you ever had that uneasy feeling where it's just like something kind of feels a little uncomfortable, but it's not the good uncomfortable, like you're about to change. It's that kind of gross feeling uncomfortable, like you really need to take a shower. And so what I'll do when I hear that music, and if it's somewhere public, like I'm in the gym or something like that, I just start humming one of my songs. Hum it a little louder. And pretty soon it blocks it out, or I start to focus on things more that I don't want to. And I start to block it out. So even if you're in a public place and you can't necessarily protect yourself with what's coming in, you can still choose how you interpret that. Think about that. So again, just to wrap this up, being deliberate about your mindset. You're always going to be deliberate about your mindset. So you might as well be deliberate about your mindset, right? And with that being said, ask yourself, how can you be more deliberate about your mindset today? How can you look at, you know, the music that you listen to, the videos that you watch, the TV shows that you watch, the conversations that you have? My gosh. How many people in our lives are energy vampires, negative Nancys, pouty Paulies, right? I'm sure if I wanted to be really creative, I could try to think of some more. Like down Donald. These are just coming off the top of my head. And when you're around them, you're having conversations with them, and they just bring you down. Don't talk to those people. Or if you do, talk to them and change your perspective on listening to them. Instead of listening to them and letting them pull you down, challenge yourself to go in there and say, how can I lift this person up? Or how, more importantly, how can I walk away from the conversation uplifted myself? All right? So I hope this has been of value to you. I hope this helps. Again, this is what, my third time on here, so I appreciate you on here. I appreciate all you have hitting the heart button. I'm going to learn more and more how to integrate this into all the other social media stuff, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, et cetera, as time goes on. And again, those of you who are here, I appreciate you taking the time and sharing this and clicking the heart button and everything else. And I hope this helps out. And, you know, apply it, start applying it right away. Send me a comment or an email on Facebook. Let me know how it is, how it's working out for you. And we'll do more of these again soon. Okay? Have a good one, guys. Take care.